Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. My brothers and sisters, mind your language. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, reminds us that everything we utter is written down. And so he says to us, "Man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawmil akhiri falyaqul khayran aw liyasmut." Whoever truly believes in Allah and in the Day of Judgment, meaning the last day, should either say that which is good or remain silent, primarily because it will be held against you on the Day of Judgment, unless you seek the forgiveness of Allah. Now, many of us, we follow the trends and the norms of societies and communities. These trends and norms, if they happen to be good, alhamdulillah, meaning all praise is due to Allah. But if they happen to be unacceptable, you can ignore them. You need to abstain. For example, the usage of the F word, the B word, the P word, whatever else it may be, in a derogatory way, abusive and so on. To be honest, we can do without it. It costs us nothing to cut it out of our vocab. Please be conscious of the words you utter. I am saying this because it will help me, it will help you, it will help all of us on the Day of Judgment. And primarily, if we were to cleanse our language, we earn a reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we have definitely maintained the self-respect and dignity to begin with. And secondly, we will earn the blessings of Allah, what is known as barakah. And so this barakah that descends and falls upon us will be felt in all our affairs, in our health, in our wealth, in our dealings, in our sustenance, in our deen and dunya, meaning your spirituality, religion, your worldly matters and affairs, and everything else, your children, your siblings, your offspring, your family members, your household, your movements, your earnings, everything, because your language was always clean. You only uttered good words. And good words are the words of praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, subhanallah, la ilaha illallah, mashallah, tabarakallah. But what we need to know is to stay away from bad language and swear words. Literally, swear words. The F word is being used. Wallahi, my beloved children who are listening to me today, and the teenagers, even the adults. We use this word simply because we want to sound cool, we want to fit in, we say it, we type it, we tweet it, we use it on social media, we video it. This is not good. It actually snatches away the blessings. Then we're wondering why we're feeling so difficult, negative, whatever else it may be, anxiety and so many other things. One of the reasons is because we don't use good language. We don't have self-respect. We don't carry ourselves with dignity. Use good words. Mind your language. Subhanallah. Imagine arriving on the Day of Judgment. All your books are spread in front of you. And all you see is every little while there's an F and a B and so on. And a P and a Z and a U and an L and a W. And all these words, subhanallah, that are derogatory and bad, demeaning, abusive, vulgar, to say the least. And you say, "I was just joking about it." We don't joke about vulgar words. And even if the trends happen to be that people are saying these words, we don't need to. You can do away with it, and you should. My brothers and sisters, if you don't want the blessings to be snatched away, please polish your language a little bit. When I say polish, I mean take out the bad words, even if it's jokingly or to your friends. Remove them. Replace them with good words. And this is actually the bare minimum before you even start declaring the praise of Allah. How do you expect the acceptance to say good words and to read the Quran and to declare the praise of Allah when your tongue is filthy and dirty with all sorts of swear words throughout the day? Subhanallah, joking or not joking? Let's cut it out, my brothers and sisters. I promise you, you will taste great blessings and barakah in all your affairs, simply because you've cleansed your tongue. مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. Whoever believes in Allah and the last day should utter that which is beneficial, which is good, or remain silent. May Allah forgive our shortcomings and make us more conscious of what we utter, help us eradicate the bad words, and help us increase good and good words. آمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.